as Cortez Bryant, and I'm a proud alumnus of the Jackson State University. I had the privilege of marching for the best marching band in the country, the Sonic Boom of the South.
The band means an awful lot to HBCUs all across the nation. When you think about PWIs and athletics, you think about band and HBCUs in the same ways. As it relates to the sense of culture, it means everything. You ask anybody that goes to an athletic event, it can be a football game or a basketball game, you would ask them, hey, did you come to see the football team? They would say yes, but they will also say that they come to see the band as well. I was a young boy who came out of a very impoverished area, and I used band to change my surroundings. I used band and music to power my future.
The Sonic Boom has played such a major part in my life and the man I am today. My tenure there was so important because I learned so many valuable lessons like leadership and working together. You're only strong as the weakest link. These are all things and principles that I took into my later life and my professional career. Upon graduation from Jackson State, I got a call from my best friend, who you guys may know as Lil Wayne, asking me to be his manager. I didn't know anything about management or music or the music business. The only things I had to tap into in the beginning was my experiences that I had at Jackson State and being part of the Sonic Boom.
The history of the Sonic Boom of the South actually runs pretty deep. It started off in the mid-1920s as a small group, but they formally got its start in 1940, and the band was called a small band with a big band sound. In 1992, we had Dr. Louis Liddell, who served as my band director, who gave me an opportunity in the Sonic Boom of the South, and finally, I'm here as director of bands here at Jackson State University. I had the coveted opportunity of getting the job this year during the COVID pandemic. It means a lot more to me than a job. It's a way of life because I get to give those same experiences to 300 students who will one day take this place.
The school's meant that much to me. I brought Wayne here. Drake's been here a couple times. He loved it. He lost his mind. I started an endowment fund in my band director's name. Dr. Louis Liddell, I donated $500,000, which allows kids like me who may not have the opportunity to go to college and receive scholarships and keep the band program soaring. Jackson State, we turned up. We got Coach Prime. Football gonna be up. Music program gonna be up. We live at HBCUs, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, fine-tune your sensory apparatus for the utmost and the acme and pinnacle of the most incredible and exquisite sights and sounds found in any band performance, anytime and anywhere. Please welcome the summa cum laude of